my second novel, The Ecliptic, is set at a strange, mysterious colony for artists, a refuge, in fact, called Portmantle, which is on an island called Heybeliada off the coast of Istanbul. And we join our narrator, Nell, as she's known, at some point in the past, we're not sure quite when, and a young artist called Fullerton is about to join the refuge and disturb everything that's settled and in place. And from there, we go backwards and we understand more about Nell Elspeth and how she came to be at this place. And we follow her life as a painter in the late 1950s, early 1960s in London. And the novel is really an exploration of art and artistic integrity and what that means. It's a novel which is a human story, so it follows Elspeth's sort of burgeoning romance with a fellow painter in London, and how it results in her having to flee and go to this strange place that nobody knows about, apart from a few artists who've been invited to go. So it's a literary mystery. It's many different things, but hopefully readers of my first novel will be able to recognize the style and the atmosphere that I create in my first book might well be reflected in this one too. I think readers might have to be slightly more patient with this book, but I think it will reward them as much in following the story and figuring out what it's about. I am a big reader. I think you have to be as a writer. You know, if you're not reading, then you're not ever really informing your own technique. With this book, I had a very sort of particular set of writers in mind who happened to be my favorite writers. So American writers of the 40s, 50s, and 60s have a style that I wanted to try and reflect in, in parts of this book. So writers like Carson McCullers and Shirley Jackson, John Cheever, Richard Yates, you know, people who are writing very descriptive but expressive style that I try to emulate as much as I can and hopefully get somewhere towards. But equally, I think I'm a writer who likes to tell a story as well. I don't like to get too hung up on my own literary style. I try and make sure that something is happening and bubbling under the surface of the book at all times, so that the reader knows that this is leading somewhere and it will reward their patience if they keep to it.